some visitors amongst us here today.
We were in the service together with your pastor.
I haven't seen these men in decades. They represent a dark period in my life.
That went down awfully quick.
Drinking for two now that you got old and boring. Shine down a
light on me. Because of my son, I came here, found you guys. A year ago, we joined the Corps, and then 2 days ago, they told me that he'd been killed. He's gonna be buried in Arlington, and I was wondering if you guys could come with me. I've come to
you in search of some. He sent him off to a godforsaken desert. Why?
Hi, welcome to What the Flick. I am Christy. This is Alonzo. We are in the thick of award season, and this superficially might look like an awardsy kind of movie. It's the latest from Richard Linklater called Last Flag Flying. Alonzo is going to tell us about it.
So yeah, it stars Steve Carell as a guy who tracks down two old army buddies played by Bryan Cranston and Laurence Fishburne because his son has died in Iraq. It's 2003, and he wants their help to bury him at Arlington, but plans change along the way, and it leads to something of a road trip with these three old friends who have gone in very different paths in their lives, kind of reconnecting and figuring out where they are now and where the world is now. Take a look. Old
man, look. The thing that made Larry different from the rest of us, he had a happy childhood.
He said that?
Yes, sir.
If there's 1 minute that's not too terrible, I'd like to try to enjoy it.
His holiness can hardly walk, let alone handle a big rig with a hydraulic lift.
This is a rental with an automatic transmission.
You guys ready for an adventure? Let's go. Old man, take a look at my life. I'm a lot
like you. I need some. What do you smell?
Urine.
I love it. It's like the official scent of the city.
Things that come into your head and out of your mouth.
You worry too much. That's why your hair went so gray.
Could you resist a man in this uniform?
I don't think I could.
You're there for your brothers. Yeah, that's all that really matters.
I love Richard Linklater. I'm a big fan. And this film, he co-wrote with Darryl Ponicsan, who wrote The Last Detail. Mm-hmm. And apparently the book this is based on is a direct sequel to The Last Detail, but for whatever reasons, Linklater decided to change the names of the characters. But you can kind of see that Bryan Cranston is playing the Jack Nicholson character from the first one. I've not seen The Last Detail,
but
there are moments where you're watching Bryan Cranston, you're thinking, okay, you're playing a Jack Nicholson type character.
It's a swaggering and kind of profane and inappropriate. Yeah. Charming rogue character, yeah.
This movie touches on a lot of really interesting stuff, and there are scenes that really land, but overall, I found it kind of superficial. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, it doesn't. I don't know. There's something about the drama that feels kind of pat, and I didn't always necessarily buy the relationships between these three guys, which is sort of what the movie is kind of built on. I can't quite put my finger on it, but I just remember watching and thinking this should be better.
Right, it's just not working. That's how I felt too. There's something kind of weirdly inert about it, and all the pieces are in place. You have these three great actors. They are total pros. They have lovely chemistry with each other. Richard Linklater can make every kind of movie and has made every kind of movie, so why not make a war drama or a post-war drama? But yeah, it doesn't click for some reason. I'm with you, I can't really put a finger on why it didn't work for me, but maybe it's about expectations. Maybe it's like, we thought this should be great and it's not, versus just going into it.
I don't even think it's, it's not even like, oh, it's not a grand statement, but it does sort of operate on this sort of more low-key level. There's something about it where you can just sort of feel the elements of it butting up against each other, and it just doesn't quite, I don't know, there's a missing emotional impact here. The stuff that it has to say about war and, you know, what it does to young men and what it does to old, or, you know, and the old men that some of those young men turn into, didn't necessarily feel all that revelatory. I thought there were some interesting ideas about the lies that the governments tell the people, or the people tell each other, about heroism or about the glories of battle, and why sometimes we need that, even if it's totally not true. But again, I'm thinking of these more as like ideas that the film is going after, as opposed to things that it really delivers on.
Yeah, the naturalism that is his style, that he is known for, serves him well in several scenes. Like, I think notably the scene where Steve Carell, you know, he insists on seeing his child's body, and that sounds like it might be really mawkish or melodramatic, and it's not. Like the fact that Linklater knows how to hold back and let moments unfold for themselves. Like he holds back physically too with where
he puts it. It's in the back of the frame.
Yeah, and so you know that serves him well. But then some of the humor is kind of hacky. Like when the guys go and get cell phones for the first time, it's kind of like we see so many old man comedies where they like struggle to use
technology.
You know, or like there's no Viagra jokes in it, thank God. But like, but that kind of thing where it's like a hacky kind of easy humor to go to, and it's like, I don't know. It didn't really work. But, you know, but they, again, they bounce off one another nicely.
There's a nice scene with Cicely Tyson as the mother of somebody that they served with. Yeah, I can't quite put my finger on it, but this seems like a disappointment. But I mean, if you're a Linklater fan, you should check it out. You know, it might be that it'll work for you. I mean, I just saw it a couple days ago, and I'm still sort of trying to wrap my head around why this didn't.
I saw it a while ago. Actually.
Land for me.
I think also just there. Although these actors are all great, they're not given much to do beyond like the broad brushstrokes of who they're playing, right?
True. Once they're introduced to you, they don't change a lot. Mm-hmm. I mean, like Fishburne's character is a preacher now, and we get the impression that in his past he was much more, a hedonist. Mm-hmm. But early on, he curses pretty quickly, so we know that like still under the surface somewhere is the crazy guy that he used to be. Mm-hmm. So yeah, there's not a real arc for anybody.
Right. Not unlike Bad Mom's Christmas. They all stay in their lanes. Once they get their lane.
I don't know, there's been a lot of comparison between those two.
But that's why we do what we do here.
There you go.
To make that comparison.
We watch everything for you guys.
Yes, so I'm saying 5.5.
I'll say 6. I mean, this is a competent film. It's well shot. Mm-hmm. There's some nice supporting side characters. But yeah, just on the whole, it doesn't.
Yes. So 5.8 is our number. It's a 71% on the tomato meter. And Thor comes out this week too. We've also already reviewed Thor. So somewhere, maybe up there.
On the side, check it out.
It will say Thor. You can click on that review too. So it's a big week for big stuff and small stuff. And it's November. Bye. Yeah.